Hey, what's up guys? This is Vincent, and in this Lightroom Classic tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the crop tool in the develop module. So right now I'm in the develop module and I'm going to select a photo to crop or to demonstrate the crop tool. So to open up the crop tool, you click on this icon right here, or you can press the keyboard shortcut R, and this opens up the crop tool. And to start with the crop tool, we have the aspect or the aspect ratios. Right now it's the original ratio and the ratio is locked. So if I bring my mouse here to this corner, I can change the crop as I want by selecting the corners or the sides. If I want to unlock the ratio, I just click on this icon here and then I can unlock it. And now I can crop as freely as I want. So I'm going to reset this. I can also choose a ratio. Common ratio is 16 by 9. And then I can use this aspect tool to draw it out if I want to with the mouse. So I'm just drawing it out. And depending on which direction you draw the aspect, it'll come out as a landscape orientation if I'm scrolling it to the right. If I scroll the mouse a little bit down, it now changes to portrait. And so forth. I can also rotate it by just bringing the mouse right outside of the crop or the frame, and then I can rotate it as I want. I'll just click reset. And now we have this angle tool. The angle tool straightens out the image. There's the auto option. It doesn't work in this because it could not figure out the image. So I'll go to this photo here. And I'll click on auto and let's see what happens. So there was a slight change. Let me reset it. If you look at the edges here or here, and I click on auto, so it improved it to the crop and straighten it out. It also depends on like what's on the foreground and what's on the background, as well as if there's any lens distortion that you may or may not need to straighten out an image. But anyways, let me reset this and let me show you how to use the angle tool. So the angle tool is just for you to manually select an area that you want to be leveled. So I already clicked the angle tool here. I go to the image. This looks, if you can see it, this looks straight, this area of grass. And then I can just drag it, let go of the mouse, and then it automatically straightens it. I can also use this slider here to change the angle. And so forth. Another thing is like when I'm cropping from the sides or the corner, you notice it picks up the crop along the other side of the edge or the other corner. If you want to crop from the middle, let me just reset this. If I want to crop from the middle, I just click on the corner, option or alt click, and then drag the mouse. And now it crops from the middle. Let me go ahead and reset this. Okay, so now we have the constraint to image. This isn't going to work on this photo, but pretty much is to make sure the crop is within all the photo and does not include any negative or cut out or cropped area. I'll show you an example in a second, but I'll show you how it doesn't work right now because this whole crop is filled up. But if I go to the transform tool, which I'll show you later on in a different video, and I click on the aspect, I change the aspect of the actual photo. Now you can see there's this white space. Let me go back to the crop tool, and the white space is not included in the crop. But if I uncheck it, now I can include this white space. So most of the time you don't need this constraint to image, but it's a good idea to keep it on. Let me just reset this transform. Double click it. And now I'll go back to the crop tool. So I'm going to reset it right now. I'll go to this photo. So as you can see, there's like an overlay. This is the rule of thirds overlay. If you want to change the overlay, you can go to tools, go to crop guide overlay, and then you have a few options. So I'll go to the golden spiral. I'll choose another one. I'll go to golden ratio, or let me check out triangle. And here's the different overlays. You can also press O while you're in the crop tool to go through the different overlays, or you can press Shift O. Actually, this isn't a good example. Let me go to the spiral. So you can press Shift O on this and it'll rotate the overlay. So the crop tool is pretty easy to use. Most of the time you only need to use it for like 1 or 2 minutes at the beginning or end of your workflow. If you guys enjoyed this video, give it a like, subscribe, and follow me on Instagram. Have a good one.